books. The diagram of one kind of a section of this stem has been made. Okay, it's just one kind of a section, cross section. For this cross section, basically, if we see this is a stem, okay, hum consider karte hain ye chalk kya hai mera, this is a stem. And isme agar aap ye rounded portion, aap dekh sakte hain, that is the cross section, that is the chalk is having the rounded circle configuration, hai na, ye pura aisa aisa structure hota hai iska. So if you cut it like this, is chalk ko agar aap is tarah se section mein cut karte hain, thin section cut karte hain, you will be getting its cross section in the rounded shape. Round milega na aapko section iska, and you place it on the slide and you view it. ठीक है? अगर आप इसको पूरा longitudinal section इस तरह से cut करते हैं, we call it as LS. And when we cut it through this form, that is आप इस तरह से इसको cut करोगे, यानी ये अगर मेरे पास stem है, and I am cutting it like this way. Okay? I am making a cut on this side. We will be getting the TS. It is a thin section. We place it on the slide and we view it. Okay? When we are viewing the structure of the stem, it's one kind of a stem, not all. It is having variety of the variations in the features in it. Okay, but the one which we are going to draw is the one which is given in your NCERT. So, pura circle form mein hum iska cross section nahi bana rahe. Maine aapko ye kyu bataya? Kyunki ye pura circle form mein cross section nahi draw kar rahe. We will be only drawing the cross section, that is only a part of it. ठीक है, हम सिर्फ इसका एक part जो है वो draw करने लगे हैं. जैसे ये हमारे पास, दिस इज ओनली अ पार्ट ऑफ इट. ओके, आई हैव मेड एन आउटलाइन, आई एम मेकिंग जस्ट अ पार्ट ऑफ द होल सर्कल, दैट इज अ स्टेम क्रॉस सेक्शन का ड्राइंग में सिर्फ पार्ट बना. ठीक है, अपर मोस्ट लेयर आउट हेयर दैट इज मेड अप ऑफ एपिडर्मिस एंड दिस इज द शेप ऑफ द एपिडर्मल सेल्स. द एपिडर्मिस दैट हैज द हेयर्स प्रेजेंट. Okay, some of the stems, if you will look, they will be also showing the presence of the hairs as it is present for the roots. ठीक है, जैसे roots में root hair होते हैं, ऐसे ही stems के ऊपर भी hairy projections होती हैं. ठीक है, and also the hairs which are present, they can be the hairs which are multicellular or which are unicellular hairs. ठीक है, so this is one type of the hair, multicellular, which we are going to make in this structure. Okay. ये पूरा इस चीज को हम बोलते हैं सिंगल सेल, दिस इज यूनिसेलुलर, द होल सेल इज यूनिसेलुलर, है ना, वन सेल. लेकिन जब आप इसमें मेम्ब्रेन्स बना देंगे, दैट इज व्हेन यू बाइफर्केट इट इनटू द स्मॉलर सब यूनिट्स, इट इज मेड अप ऑफ मेनी नंबर ऑफ द सेल्स एंड यू शो इट इन द डायग्राम, देन इट इज मल्टी सेलुलर. राइट, हाउ आई एम मेकिंग दिस, सपोज दिस इज द हेयर विच आई हैव शोन. ओके, एंड इन दिस यू कैन जस्ट सिंपली मेक द इरेगुलर लाइन्स showing the different cells that which comprises the multicellular hair like this. Okay, so this is a multicellular hair. Fine, similarly the other hair will also be multicellular one, so you can draw the small irregular portions in this. Clear? The whole is the epidermis having the multicellular hairs on it. Now below the epidermis is present the hypodermis. Hypodermis is made up of which type of the tissues? That is the collenchyma tissue. The collenchyma tissues, they are having the thick walled structures, and these thick walled structures, they are either thickly, you can say the thickenings, they are deposited either on the whole of the wall or the thickenings are present over the corners only. Okay, this is present over the corners only. So this is the cross section of the, sorry, these are the cells that comprises the hypodermis layer. So this is hypodermis. It is multiple layered, and these are multiple layered, and the multi-layered are the multi-layered structure which I am not showing here in this whole of the diagram. But in your books, you can see it has multiple layers. Okay, so just to show multiple layer, I'm making two of these. Now, because they are having the thick walls hoti hain ki, so aap thickening pure mein agar color karoge, isko cover karoge, to wo bahut zyada time consuming hoga. Uske liye humne kya karna hai? Simple, aapne isko double line show kar di. ठीक है, सारे cells में double lining show कर दीजिए, that shows it is having the thick walls. ठीक है, सो व्हेन एवर यू विल बी ड्रॉइंग दीज डायग्राम्स इन फ्यूचर, इवन यू विल बी मेकिंग द थिकनिंग्स जस्ट बाय द डबल लाइंस. Okay, so that is less time consuming, and this is also done, right? So these are the layers, the multiple layers, that of hypodermis, which comprises of polangyma cells. Alongside, you can also produce the labeling. This is the multicellular hair. Then there is epidermis. This is the layer of epidermis. As now, this is the stem section. So the outermost is called as epidermis. Then are the layers of hypodermis. These are the layers of hypodermis, followed by cortex. Now this hole will be covered with the parenchyma cells again. The parenchyma cells, they comprises the two layers further, that is one cortex, and the last will be the pith. Okay, pith is present at the last. Now, before making the cortex shells, there are the xylem and the phloem patches which are present. So for making the xylem and the phloem patches, they should be made on the same radii, number one. ठीक है, एक चीज ये सेम रेडियाई पे बनाने, अपने ऐसे सेम लाइंस बनाना जैसे सर्कल होता है पूरा. ठीक है, देन दीज आर द पैचेस. लेट्स से दीज आर द एरियाज. द पैचेस मींस दीज आर द एरियाज व्हिच हैव द जाइलम एंड द फ्लोएम अरेंज्ड अलोंग विद द कैम्बियम. वी हैव स्टडीड द एक्टिविटी ऑफ द कैम्बियम ऑल्सो. ठीक है, सो यू विल बी मेकिंग दीज इन द इक्वल लेंथ. ट्राई टू मेक दीज ऑफ द इक्वल लेंथ like this. Okay, these will be made in the equal lengths, right? Now here the two of the patches, they are formed, and in the two patches there are xylem and the phloem along with the cambium, right? So for this you will be first bifurcating the zone for the phloem. Right, this is the zone for the phloem. Then there is the zone for the cambium. You can make the zone, cambium zone, a bit thinner. थोड़ा सा thin बना सकते हैं, as in comparison. And then there will be followed after by the xylem tissue. Okay. So how to make the phloem? First of all, the phloem cells, they will be made as in the form of very small sized thin cells. ठीक है, छोटे छोटे से cells बनाने हैं. कैसे बना रही हूँ मैं, ये देखिए ये लाइन है, एंड हेयर यू आर टू मेक दीज इरेगुलर सेल्स. इरेगुलरली शेप्ड मैं यहाँ बड़े बना रही हूँ, पर वहां डायग्राम में आप इस तरह से इसको स्मॉल बनाएंगे. ठीक है, इरेगुलर सेल्स इरेगुलरली प्लेस्ड लाइक दिस. ओके, कैन बी हेक्सागन, कैन बी पेंटागन, बट वेरी स्मॉल इन साइजेस विच आर टू बी फॉर्म्ड हेयर इन दी इन दिस जोन, अपर जोन, एंड दैट इज द जोन ऑफ फ्लोएम. Right, layer count is not required, as I told you that in this there is, I'm making two layers of the hypodermis. You can even make three layers, four layers, right? It is multiple layer. Okay, so similarly you'll be making this patch of phloem over here also. This patch of the phloem that also continues with the xylem. That is in the same patch, there is the xylem and the phloem both present together. But as this is one type of the structure, the others may also show separated xylem and phloem patches. In a few, cambium is present. In a few, cambium is not present. So always it is correct, right? Here, so this is, we have made a patch with the phloem at the top, then continued further by continuing further with the cambium now. So in between, these are the cells of the cambium. So we will be making the flattened cells like this, elongated and flattened. So these are the cells of cambium, right? You have demarcated the zone for it. These are the cells of cambium. Now how I'm making the cambium cells? This is simple, flattened and elongated like this. Okay, these are the cambium cells. So cambium, okay, followed after by this cambium is the further next, that is the xylem. Now for xylem, it is of two types. You are not to go for the types of the xylem. But yes, make sure that when you are making the xylem in this, the size of the circles will be reducing towards the tip. ठीक है, बिल्कुल एंड तक नहीं लेके जाना. सर्कल साइज रिड्यूसेस, दैट इज मैंडेटरी. ओके, दिस यू हैव टू रिड्यूस बिकॉज इट इज अ टाइप ऑफ द जाइलम, इट इज अ स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ द जाइलम, अकॉर्डिंगली इट इज रिड्यूसिंग टुवर्ड्स द टिप. एंड हाउ मेनी सर्कल्स आई एम मेकिंग इन वन रो, दैट इज ऑल्सो नॉट नेसेसरी टू बी नोटेड आउट. सो दिस इज हाउ द जाइलम इज अरेंज्ड इन द फॉर्म ऑफ रोज एंड द साइज डिक्रीजेस डाउन द स्ट्रक्चर. Similarly, you'll make it for another patch. You can make a single patch. You can make two patches. You can make three patches, depending upon your speed of drawing the diagram and depending upon how much time you have for making the diagram. Okay, this is the xylem. So labeling these three parts now. The upper band, this one is all the phloem. Then there is the middle band, that of cambium, and then the circles, they are of xylem. Surrounding these are the circles further also. Iske saath mein, iske back side pe bhi circular structures present hote hain. They are also the cells that which supports the vascular tissue. Theek hai? So you can cover it like this if you want, if you have the time. Otherwise you can even leave it as empty, but show it at least in one of the patches so that it is clear that these are having some extra cells also. Apart from the xylem, they are also covered with these cells, that which makes its ground tissue. Okay, like this. Clear? Similarly on the other. But you also please differentiate between the circles of the xylem and the circles surrounding it. Okay, so here I'm making this in a colorful way, but in papers you can't make it for colorful. You will be only using the circles, but you can differentiate the two circles by making one as dark ones and the other as light ones, so that you will be having the good look of the clear structure of this cross section like this. So the circles that are surrounding the xylem circles, you can also view it that I am making it with a light hand and they are light in their color, right? This is the vascular bundle, that which comprises of xylem, phloem and cambium. Done. Now after this, they also have the structure that is of cortex. So the cells of cortex, these are present just above the patch of this xylem and the phloem. Just above this, there is also a zone of sclerenchyma. ठीक है, बिल्कुल इससे ऊपर थोड़ा सा zone of sclerenchyma भी होता है. Dhiren, just wait a minute. Let me finish, then I'll come to your questions. जस्ट इसके ऊपर ऊपर, मतलब यहाँ यहाँ जैसे कैप है, कैप स्ट्रक्चर बन सकता है इसके ऊपर. तो दैट इज ऑफ द सक्लेरेनकाइमा. ठीक है, इसके ऊपर सक्लेरेनकाइमेटस टिश्यू भी प्रेजेंट है एंड दैट इज थिकली, यू कैन से अरेंज्ड. ठीक है, सो इस तरह से आपने ये थिकली अरेंज्ड सेल्स बनाने हैं, अगेन डिफ्रेंशिएटिंग देम फ्रॉम द सराउंडिंग. एंड बिकॉज दे आर थिकली अरेंज्ड, सो व्हाट यू विल बी डूइंग, यू विल बी अगेन मेकिंग देम विद द डबल लाइंस. Or you can darken the walls even. Just above each patch, you can view these sclerenchymatous tissues. Okay, like this. Fine. And surrounding these, there is the cells of cortex, rounded, having the big intercellular spaces in them. So these are the rounded cells that which cover up the structure around the vascular bundle. Okay, similarly you'll be making the cap like structure just above the other patch also, like in the same way as you did for this one. And when you are making it, make these cells as thickened, because that is its feature. Ye feature hai uska, hai na, तो हम उसको थिन वॉल नहीं रख सकते हैं, यू हैव टू मेक इट थिक वॉल बिकॉज इट इज द सेल्स ऑफ स्क्लेरेन्काइमा विच आर थिकली वॉल्ड स्ट्रक्चर्स, दैट इज दे आर हैविंग द मैक्सिमम डिपोजिशंस इन कंपैरिजन टू द अदर सिंपल परमानेंट टिश्यूज. Done. In between are the cells of cortex, right? So these are all lined by the cortex cells. Now around them they have the cortex cells, which are made up of what type of the tissue? That is a parenchymatous tissue. Cortex consists of what type of the tissue? That is parenchymatous tissue. Okay. So parenchymatous tissue, that are the layers of cortex. So what is this layer in between? That is the double walled जो हमने बनाई है. This is a sclerenchyma tissue. ठीक है, this is a sclerenchyma. This is a sclerenchyma tissue. Followed after by these cells. These are the cells of or the layer of cortex. Okay. Now the last part, that which is left, that is down here, there is pith that again consists of the parenchyma cells only, but this time the parenchyma cells are very large enough, covering the central part of the structure, cross section of the stem, the one which is drawn in your books. Okay, so this is the cross section of the stem. Got it? So this is the cross section of the stem, and the last part, this is termed as pith. We call it as pith. Done. So this is the structure. Now the questions, please. Dhiren, you were raising your hand.